Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2300. Subtract one delimited list from another. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, hey, the brand new Mr. Excel message board. And one of the questions that came up today was help with delimiting strings. Hey, all right, here's an interesting question. So we have a whole list of names, 1500 names here on the left-hand side, and their order from yesterday, raspberry, starfruit, and their order from today, which has starfruit, raspberry, but then they've added tangerine and yuzu. How do we try and figure out what's new today? And the way I'm going to do this is with Power Query. So I'm going to take yesterday's data, Ctrl+T to make it into a table. My table has headers. We'll call that yesterday. And then over here, Ctrl+T to make it into a table. My table has headers. And today, we're going to use sort of a new function that came along in Excel 2016 here, data from a table or range in the get and transform data group. Back in Excel 2016, it was over here in the third group. So we'll say table from a table or range. And I'm going to take the yesterday field, split column by delimiter. And it's smart enough to figure it out. Oh, no, it didn't. It figured out we'll choose comma at each occurrence of the delimiter, and then advanced options. We're going to say split to rows, like that. Click OK. And we're getting it, but there's spaces here. So I'm going to right click and transform and choose trim. There we are. So now we have the names with the items. And instead of close and load, I'm going to choose close and load to only create a connection. Click OK. All right, so we're halfway there. Then from the second one, from table or range, choose that column, same step, split column by delimiter. The delimiter is going to be a comma. Advanced options, split into rows. Click OK. Right click, transform, trim. Good. All right. Close and load. Close and load to. Only create a connection. Click OK. All right, now we have these two queries here, connections. We'll go to get data from our actually combined queries, and then merge. So the merge dialog, we're going to say we're going to take yesterday and today, and we're going to merge it first on name, control click on yesterday, first on name, control click on today. So the one there, the one there, the two there, the two there. And what I want is I want the rows only in second, rows only in second. So that way, if something Andy Raspberry was in both places, then it will not show up. But I'll get only the items that are in the second. Click OK and expand this table to get name and today. Click OK. All right, so Andy added tangerine, Andy added yuzu. Barb added honeydew. We don't really need these two columns over here, so I'll right click and say remove those columns. And then finally home, close and load. And that should be everything that's new today. Now, the cool thing about Power Query is tomorrow, you know, this data from today is essentially going to become yesterday's data. So I'll copy that over and something's going to change, right? So we'll come out here and add something new like grapefruit. And then lime, lemon, citrus, cattle, I don't know, right? And then something. All right, you get the idea. They've added some new stuff. All we would have to do tomorrow to see those new things would be to come here and data, queries, and connections. We'll get this panel along the left-hand side, refresh, and it'll show just the new things, right? So while it takes... Oh, wow, 4 minutes to get it set up the first day. It's just going to be awesome going forward like that. Well, hey, if you find these videos helpful, please subscribe and ring the bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.